Hello everyone. Myself, Dr. Dinesh, final year postgraduate from Osmania Medical College, Hyderabad. My topic is on role of multidrugosity in evaluation of colorectal lesions with histopathological correlation. Introduction. As you all know, CT is an increasingly useful technique in evaluation of intestinal diseases along with evaluation of other extra-intestinal manifestations. Important CT findings for colorectal lesions include defining the wall thickening, which can be focal, segmental, or diffuse. The wall thickening is symmetrical or asymmetrical involvement of the bowel lumen. There is a smooth or irregular or lobulated inner or outer contour and the degree of pattern of enhancement. Associated any adjacent inflammatory change like any mesenteric inflammatory response or an abscess or phlegmon or associated lymphadenopathy or distal metastatic deposits, which provide an additional important feature helpful in narrowing the differential diagnosis. MDCT is also useful in assessing the depth of involvement of possible neoplasm to identify pericolic spread, including lymph node undetected colorectal liver metastasis. Hence, this study is an attempt to characterize the wall thickening in patients with colorectal lesions as either benign or malignant based on different features. This study aims at evaluating the role of CT in tumor staging of malignant lesions. CT findings are finally correlated with histopathological findings. Aims and objective: to study the accuracy of MDCT in diagnosis of colorectal lesions and to study the effectiveness of MDCT in differentiating neoplastic from non-neoplastic lesions and to study the accuracy of MDCT in preoperative tumor staging of colorectal malignancies. A prospective type of study is carried out in the Department of Radiation Diagnosis and Imaging at Osmania General Hospital. Patients with suspicion of large bowel lesions were included in the study. A CT was performed. CT was performed using 128 slice scanner. All patients are placed on spine position in CT table, and a room air was gently insufflated into the colon to get adequate colonic distension. And then imaging is performed in arterial phase, portal venous, and with section width of 5 mm. Informed consent was taken from each patient prior to enrollment in the study. Inclusion criteria: all patients suspected to have inflammatory, obstructive, ischemic, and neoplastic diseases of the large bowel disease. Large bowel were included in the study. Patients with histopathological findings are available for correlation also included. Exclusion: patients with past history of chronic renal failure or allergic reaction to contrast were excluded. Patients with in whom histopathologic correlation is not available, they are excluded from the study. Actually, this is an first case where we could see asymmetrical circumferential thickening not involving sigmoid colon of varying length with HSN asymmetrical thickening, not a non-sigmoid colon with perimesenteric fat staining, and multiple mesenteric lymph nodes are also visualized. In this case, there are also metastatic lymphocytes in liver. Case of an CA sigmoid colon with the liver mets T3N2N1. Other case of case of appendicitis with the thick and diffuse long segment thickening of cecum and ascending colon noted. Suggestive of colitis. Another case where we could see as asymmetrical circumferential thickening of cecum and ascending colon order with dilated small bowel loops with multiple enlarged lymph nodes, where in this case we could also see multiple air pockets noted in retroperitoneum, and these air pockets are seen not extending into the mediastinum. Positive pneumoperitoneum with the pneumomediastinum likely secondary to ascending colon perforation. And next case, very good. See, ill-defined heterogeneously isolated hyperdense area with fat standing noted in left leg fossa adjacent to lower aspect of descending colon with central area of preserved fat, suggestive of epiploid appendicitis. The case of RC esophagus, patient was in post-RT, where we could see multiple retroperitoneal deposits encasing aorta and SMB with gross ascites and descent long segment circumferential thickening of ascending colon with maximum wall thickness of 8 mm, suggestive of inflammatory colitis. another case of sigmoid cross structure, where you can see segmental circumferential wall thickening of sigmoid colon with the moderate ascites and omental thickening order, suggests your abdominal tuberculosis with stricture. Another case of CA transesperon, where you can see yield by asymmetric circumferential thickening of ordinary transesperon with extra luminal component, loss of patulins with adjacent small bowel loops noted. And in this case, there are also multiple omental peritoneal deposits were also seen. For this case of CA, this case of CA transesperon with multiple peritoneal deposits, T3, N2, M1 aspect stage. A result in a study of 100 patients with wall thickening in all the region of colon and rectum. 68 patients were males and 36 were female. Age group was commonly affected by more than 50 years of age. Among these, 64 patients were histologically proven to be malignancy and 28 cases were proved to be benign. Of the 64 malignant cases, 26 were stage 1 and stage 2, 32 were stage 3, 10 lesions were stageless T4 based on histopathology. Okay, here we could see a gender-wise distribution where males are almost there is more number of females here affected. Age distribution, maximum age affected was between 51 to 65 years of age. As we know, in this case there are more of malignancy findings than are of inflammatory, as high as 64%. Site of distribution, most common site where cecum, ascending colon, and then a transverse colon, descending colon, sigmoid colon. Sites of distribution in malignant lesions. Malignant lesions are more commonly involving in the rectum and the attenuation pattern. A homogeneous attenuation. Homogeneous attenuation was the most common finding in case of inflammatory or infected etiology, where heterogeneous mixed attenuation or stratified attenuation was seen in malignant lesions. Degree of wall thickening, most of the malignant lesions in our study showed asymmetrical thickening in contrasting to inflammatory or infected disease. This showed an symmetrical thickening, and focal segmental disease was more commonly found in malignant etiology than to an infective or inflammatory etiology. Conclusion, MDCT is an excellent imaging modality for diagnosis and differentiation of benign and malignant lesions, since it has the advantage of providing thinner sections faster acquisition. MDCT with its axial and reformated images is a useful tool to differentiate early colorectal carcinoma and advanced cancer. Besides identifying the lesion, MDCT also provides further information regarding pericolic abnormalities associated with the lesion and the presence of lymph nodes, infiltration of adjacent viscera, and presence of distant metastasis. These are my references. Thank you.